Hi there. This video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there. This cool little video is using the same techniques we learned in the last video using the Liquify tool, but we're going to turn it into drippy text. You can do the same thing with a logo or maybe an icon. Let's jump in now and learn how. First up, let's open up our image. You can use any image. I'm using from your exercise files, 08 transform. There's one here called paint text 01. Open that one up. I picked this one mainly because I just wanted green as part of that finished example, but you can pick any image you like. What I find though is before we get started, it's quite nice to get rid of some of the detail. It would depend on your image and what the effect you want at the end. For the one you saw at the beginning, I went to filter, I went to noise, I went to this one called median. You can see you can crank it right up, crank it down, okay, just to get rid of some of the detail to make it more look a little bit more painterly. Let's click OK. Next thing I want to do is put my, you could put a logo here, copied and pasted from Illustrator. I'm just going to grab the type tool. The font size here is going to be quite big, about 900, maybe even bigger, 1000. Now in terms of the font here, I'm using this one called Remachine just because it's a nice kind of script. I'm going to click once, type a G, doesn't really matter what color it is. Grab the move tool, stick it in the middle. Now Remachine is a font that I've included in your exercise files. Here it is here, it's an 08 transform under font. It's a font by Mans Grebeck and it's for personal use only. If you want to use this font for commercial use, read the license, download it, pay for it. It's a pretty awesome font. I like it because it's going to kind of a swirl to it. So for this to work, we need to clip the image inside of the text. We did this in an earlier video. Have a little think, rack your brain. You're like, how do I crop the text inside of here? I'll wait here, you go do it. If you can't remember, let's practice again. So we need the image above the text, which we can't do because it's locked, but we know we can unlock a background by double clicking it. I call it green, give it a name, and then we can stick it above. And with this top one selected, we go layer, we go to this one called create clipping mask. Now with your move tool, I'm gonna move it around because I want one of the pigeons involved. I'm not really sure why. And the last thing we're gonna do is we're going to merge these two here. You should do a save as now. So you've got a backup copy. So I have two versions, this one before we went along and wrecked it, but it's wrecking time. So I'm gonna have both of these selected. I click the top one, held shift, click the second one. So they're both selected. And this little flyout menu here, there's one in there that says merge layers. Just kind of squishes them together, never to be pulled apart again. But don't worry, you got your backup. One other thing we might do is a new layer. Okay, the little turned up page here, and we're gonna go to edit, fill, and we're just gonna put fill with black. Click okay, and make sure this layer is at the bottom here. It doesn't matter, you could fill it with white or any color. It looked kind of cool on black when I was working on it. Work on the green layer here. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And what I wanna do now is I'm gonna use the Liquify tool. So let's go to filter and come down to here to this Liquify. Background disappeared, that's okay. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And what we wanna do is we're gonna use the forward warp tool and we're gonna pick a brush size that kind of fits within. You can see I'm using the square brackets to make it go bigger. Or you can drag it up here under tool size. And now it's kind of being as careful or as not careful as you want. I'm just clicking and dragging like I'm smearing the paint. Okay, you can see you can kind of accidentally go out. We'll do that on purpose in a minute. So it depends on what you're looking for. I'm just kind of doing it in little strokes, so I'm not trying to do the whole thing in one go. Just too hard. So I'm clicking, dragging, trying not to go off the line too much. Come on, mouse. Clicking, dragging, clicking, dragging. I'm okay with a couple of those bends. Okay, and then this one here, I want it to kind of swirl down across that one. All right, there was a bit up here that I missed. I'm gonna use a smaller brush size just to kind of smear him as well. And you might go over it a second time if you're not liking what you've got. Okay, I'm happy enough with it. It's kind of cool. It's not too smeary. Now, I want a couple of little drips. So I'm gonna use the exact same tool. I'm just gonna use a really small paintbrush. There's two things we need to do. One is we need to kind of get it going by clicking and do one there. I'm clicking and dragging across. Maybe a slightly bigger brush. It's 45. Straighten it up then. Wow, it's terrible. Okay, I'm gonna do one there. I'm just clicking and dragging, and maybe another one over here. Cool, and that gets us kind of part the way there, but then we're gonna use these two tools here. Remember from the last video, we're gonna use bloat and pucker. So bloat, pick a brush size. I'm gonna pick, I don't know, something that size, and just kind of click on these ends here. I'm trying to make it look like there's a bit of a drip going. Bigger brush size, there we go. That one I don't want one on, that one I do. Little, there you go. I like to use the pucker tool as well. Same sort of thing, just kind of click it in there to make it a bit thinner. All right, here we go. Same with this one, I'm gonna try and make it a little bit thinner as it's dripping down. Same with this one here, a bit too thick there, buddy. All right, and that's gonna be our paint kind of drips. I want like one of these to have a drop. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click okay. So this is gonna be it for the dragging the smearing paint around. We're gonna click okay. Looks a whole lot nicer against the black. What I want is like a little drip drop that you saw at the beginning there. I'm just gonna use the elliptical marquee tool, select a chunk of it. Maybe this bit there. Copy it and paste it. And with my move tool, I'm gonna position it somewhere there, maybe shrink it down a little bit. It's a bit too big. Using my transform tool, Command T on a Mac, Control T on a PC. Now I'm gonna go in and what I could do, I'm actually happy enough with that, but you could go into now on its own layer and start distorting it because it's maybe a bit too perfectly round. But you could go to Liquify now and push it around a little bit. I'd probably wanna fix this bit up, but I'm not going to. What I'm going to do though is show you a couple little tricks. One is if it's on white, you might add a drop shadow to it. Looks kind of cool. And I vowed never to use it, but I wanna add a bevel and emboss. I know. It might actually work in this case. I'm gonna select both of these two layers because the drop is on a different layer from this green thing. And up here again, I'm gonna do the exact same thing, merge layers. Now with it selected, I'm gonna go down to effects and I'm gonna go to bevel and emboss. Okay, I've already played with this. That's why mine kinda came out okay. Preview on, preview off, but follow me. Okay, inner bevel and then play around with things like how deep you want it to be. Okay, and the size, and it will depend on your size of your image, the size of the text you're using, so it's all gonna be a little different, but mainly depth, size, and make sure it's on inner bevel. And in my case, I'm gonna make it come from the top left, and I feel like I've gone maybe too far. So I'm gonna soften it down a little bit, actually change the size of it. Actually change the depth of it is what I want. Yeah, it's looking kind of 3D-ish. Let's click okay. That could be it. I'm gonna do one last thing. It's the burn tool. And we'll actually use the dodge tool as well. So the burn tool, remember we've used in a couple of tutorials now. Okay, on this layer here, as long as it's not a smart object, it won't work. But with the burn tool, I've set it to midtones and I've got a brush size, what is that, 125. I'm just gonna kind of, can you see I'm just painting that in there just to make it a bit more extreme, say on some of these parts. Depends on what you want to do, right? I'm going to cast a bit of a shadow onto that as well because that G's above it. So I'm just kind of messing around now with some of those lighter parts. You could do this completely instead of the bevel. And what I probably want to do is definitely on this little drips and balls here. Okay, so you clicking, dragging. This one as well. You, I've made terrible drips. Hope yours are better. All right, so those are them. Let's look at the dodge tool. It's the opposite of the burn tool. Okay, click and hold it down. There's the dodge tool. And I'm gonna do the same thing, but on the highlights. You can see just clicking a few times. Clicking gives my highlights. Where else do I want them? Maybe on this thing here. Make that side shiny. Okay, that's just ugly. But we're getting the idea, right? All right, so that is how to make a painty, drippy thing. Doesn't really matter what the object is. You could get some clip art, it could be a love heart, it could be some social media icons. But in this case, we've done some scripty text. I like it. All right, on to the next video. Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course.
Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go check that out, link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. Yeah, all right, that's enough. Hi, Dada.